structure from cotton fibers. Mechanical spinning is carried out mainly for cotton, wool, and their blends with other fibers like polyesters. The cotton fiber has to pass through the following stages during its spinning. They are opening, picking, carding, combing, drawing, roving, and spinning. Opening. The cotton arrives in the mill in large bales, from where it is brought to the blow room. The compressed mass of raw fibers in the bales is removed, then it is mixed, opened, and cleaned. The blending fiber raises cotton until part of it is knocked off by roll. The churning of cotton mixes it. Picking. The fluffy mass of fibers then moves to picking machines called scoochers. Here, the loosening and cleaning of the fibers continues, and it is then formed into a continuous white sheet called lap. A considerable amount of impurities are removed during this process. Next comes carding. The cotton from the blow room is then fed to a carding machine, where the remaining impurities are removed and the cotton is opened into individual fibers. In this machine, the lap passes between two cylinders covered with specially bent wires. Here the individual fibers are straightened and made somewhat parallel. This process of cleaning and opening the cotton into individual fibers is known as carding. The fibers emerge from the carding roll as a thin, uniform web, which is drawn in a funnel-shaped device where it gathers into a soft mass of rope of fibers called sliver. The sliver is collected into the containers called cans. Combing. The carded sliver is then fed through the comber Here fibers are combed by defined tooth combs and short fibers are removed. These combed fibers are formed into saliva called combed saliva and collected in cans. Drawing. In the drawing operation, several slivers are fed into four steps of rolls traveling in different speed. This causes the elongation of the sliver and it draws into a new sliver without any twist. This makes the sliver even and the fibers become fully parallel and straightened. Roving. After the single or several stages of drawing, the sliver is taken to a slubber where it is drawn out further to the desired shape, then twisted and wound on bobbins. At this point, up to roving, fibers are only partially twisted and have low tensile strength. They may break with a slight pull. Thank you. spinning. Next, the yarn is placed on the ring spinning frame. The yarn here passes through a traveler to a spindle which revolves and is put in an exact number of twists as the yarn is wound up on a desired bobbin. The bobbins filled with yarn are then removed from the ring frame for processing as may be desired. For example, the yarn may be formed into hanks or skeins for bleaching or may be wound on spools for weaving. Summary of the operation is given in the table in your books.